Teddy, you have questions here from viewers, actually, wondering, since you've been red tagged yourself, are you doing anything differently with your security, and what action do you plan to take?
No, wala akong kasamang police. I've been like that since I was mayor. Been going around Ifugao, wala akong really mga bodyguards. Actually, when I go in the campaign trail in Ifugao in previous elections, I get to meet the NPA rebels there. And we talk, you know. Some of them are Ifugaos themselves, no? So ngayon, even with the red tagging, not really very worried about my security. I belong to two worlds. Eh? I'm an activist, and at the same time, my family, Browners, are also military. So, so very confident when it comes to my security. Wala naman akong kaabang.
Okay. Now, there are, of course, complaints against Undersecretary Badoy, but your camp itself, are you planning to take action against her?
Ako, no. No. Temporary lang naman si Badoy, hanggang May 9 lang naman siya. After that, mawawala na yung power.
All right. Let's talk about, speaking of Badoy, the NTF-ELCAC. If you win as senator, will you keep funding the NTF-ELCAC?
This is my personal position. Ako I'll move for dismantling. Plain and simple, that's my position. Buwagin yung NTF-ELCAC.
Oo. But what about projects that are meant to go directly to communities that were once infiltrated by the NPA? That was the whole point of the NTF-ELCAC. It had funding, so then it could start... Go ahead.
Yeah, but what's the use of government agencies like the Department of Agriculture, DSWD? Then the whole point nga of our program is let's focus on developing the countryside, the impoverished places, ancestral domains. Kasi nga, statistics would show that marami sa mga pumapasok sa rebelda, sabi daw nila, are katutubo. Because of what they're experiencing within their ancestral domains. So, yun yung ating tugunan. We may still have the same budget, not under NTF-ELCAC, but let's give it to the Department of Agriculture, the National Commission for Indigenous Peoples, DepEd, bigyan ng edukasyon, no? Yung mga vulnerable groups to extremism and extremism and people or vulnerable groups who might join the insurgency. So akin yun yung aking position, eh. Not have an agency with all these powers and using the money to as conditions, no, for LGUs to harass and threaten yung mga farmers, yung mga estudyante, even yung katutubo.
Okay, so you will abolish the NTF-ELCAC if it were you. What about the rice tariffication law?
Sa akin, importation...
Considering galing kayong Nueva Ecija, right?
Yeah. We've talked to farmers, to even yung mga agricultural officials na mga LGUs na pinuntahan namin, they're very much against rice tariffication. No? Sa akin, as a policy, ang rice tariffication or importation for that matter should just be a temporary solution. Kasi talaga naman sometimes when there is a food shortage, grabe yung bagyo, o kaya yung tagtuyo, then you need importation. But ang problem, it has become the policy of government. So sa akin, review it or even possibly repeal it. Kasi ang nangyayari na ngayon is pag may problema sa agrikultura, then okay, meron naman dyang importation. That's why sa akin, maybe... focus really on helping the farmers. Kasi lagi nang sinasabi, mas mura kasi pagkain from Thailand, from Vietnam. But the reason why it's cheaper there is because the farmers are also subsidized in this country. So before we open up the Philippines to food importation, let's first empower our local producers, no? Para kaya naman nila mag-compete sa vegetables, sa food galing from our neighbors. So, sa akin,
okay.
Repeal it.
All right. Now, very quickly, what would you say is this administration's biggest failure?
the lack of coherent leadership, that to me, because it encompasses everything, whether it's responding to the crisis, you know, the health pandemic, as well as the economic crisis mm-hmm. we're facing, or even defense of our territory of the West Philippine Sea. Yun lang. Walang clear leadership ang pinapakita nitong administration.
Mm-hmm. But what would you consider its achievement?
That's a very difficult question to answer, Karen. But maybe siguro the political will, because ako, naging congressman ako eh. And there were laws that were passed, whether it's the national mental health law or the new law on HIV/AIDS.
What about BARM?
Yeah, the BARM, which I supported both in the Aquino and in this administration. Pagdating doon sa mga legislative initiatives that I have personally also pushed in Congress, and ironically, it passed during this administration. They will, no, talaga, pag sinabi nila na gusto namin ito, then it really passes through the legislative process.
Uh-oh. Now, what do you consider your biggest achievement?
Me? Well, I've been in public service for almost 30 years. And I think, personally, for me, biggest accomplishment ako is being able to fight the temptation of corruption. Your former mayor, governor, congressman, almost 30 years, talagang grabe araw-araw you face instances of, you know, enriching yourself. So I think that to me personally is my biggest accomplishment. Aside from the programs that I've instituted in Ifugao, as well as the laws that I've pushed in Congress for 9 years.
Okay. Now, in office, you were not successful in pushing for an autonomous Cordillera region.
Yeah. It's a question that I cannot answer. I think it has to be the Cordillerans themselves, because this has been presented before the Cordillera people twice. It was rejected overwhelmingly. So sa akin, the third time, if you, ako pa rin, iahain pa rin yan, but if it fails, then maybe we want something else. No? Pero ako, I still cling to the dream of having an autonomous region.
Okay.
Something that we, Makling Dulag died for during the martial law years, and I still cling to that that dream, that vision.
Okay, now the latest SWS survey, which was conducted February 25 to 28, you are at number 35 to 39. I'm sure you've seen this survey.
Actually, no. I don't look at surveys these days.
You don't look at surveys, so I'm sorry to be the one to tell you. But let me read it for you. So this is an SWS survey conducted February 25 to 28, where you are number 35 to 39. And you have old names in the survey in the top 12. But here's something interesting I want you to react on. So you have Mr. Rafi Tulfo at number 1 and Mr. Robin Padilla at number 2. Then you have two of the Estradas in the top 12 in this particular survey. There's just really one opposition candidate in this survey.
Yeah, if we are to believe the survey, if it's going to be the trend until May 9, then you'll have a Senate wherein I think 1/3 ay either mag-ina, mag-ama, magkapatid, no? And then a lot of celebrities. So you'll have political dynasties, big business, and celebrities in the Senate. And yun siguro yung kinakailangan i-disseminate pa natin sa voters. Is this the type of Senate that you want who represents you? Because you vote for your congressman to represent you. You vote for the senators to be your voice in the Senate. And yet, if you look at it, what interests are they fighting for? Big business, showbiz, political dynasties. Essentially, that's the makeup of Senate right now. Eh. Kaya sa akin, hopefully, no, what we're doing right now, Headstart is helping me. We're also going around. Sipag lang talaga. Hopefully, that numbers would improve for me. But yun nga, sa akin pa rin, at the end of the day, I still think that there is a mathematical chance that I can make it.
Really? Okay, Teddy, can we talk about these mathematical chances? What makes you say that you can make it to the top 12? Because even here, you have, I mean, Richard Gordon, based on this particular survey at number 15 to 16, and that's, he's an incumbent senator. So why do you think, Teddy, you can make it?
Well, again, sa akin, still May 9, eh. That's the final survey, no? One is the Leni base, mm-hmm. and it's increasing mm-hmm. every time you go around, no? So many people, 50,000 kagabi, 50,000 in Evelcia, an opportunity for me to explain myself to 50,000 people. And then word of mouth na lang yan. Oh, ano pa si Teddy, nakabahag. So that's something that they don't forget, no? So aside from the Leni base, then there's my own bailiw, which is Northern Luzon. Bihira ang may kandidato ang Northern Luzon. I think there are only a few of them right now. And I speak Ilocano fluently. So I'll appeal to Regions 1, 2, and Cordillera, as well as provinces which have a big Ilocano base. And then the indigenous peoples.
Yeah, yeah.
Now, of course, that's the challenge.
Do you spend for advertising, Teddy? Have you spent for advertising, or you're doing it, you're campaigning in a different way? Magkano na ba nagastos ni Teddy Baguilat?
Right now, siguro wala pang 10 million. To be honest, really. We're really mostly focusing on social media, boosting our ads, ganyan. Hopefully, we could have at least a TV ad. Sabi nila kahit isa lang eh. But I'm really targeting indigenous peoples. No? Whether I win or not, no, sa akin kasi the IP vote should also come out. That's also been my challenge. Eh. We're supposed to be 10% of the population, sabi nila. From Luzon to Mindanao, you have 110 ethnolinguistic tribes. Pero bihira lumabas ang mga katutubo pag election. And it's really very difficult. That's my challenge to galvanize the IP vote. Based on an IP agenda.
Okay. Anything you'd like to add before we go? Where are you headed next?
I'm going to Palawan tomorrow to meet the indigenous peoples, to join them sa IP summit nila. Again, as I've said, that's my focus right now, talking to tribal leaders. It's a challenge. Kaya nga, I will not be joining Leni's sortie because it's my own sortie.
Okay.
They identify kasi with me because of my work in the House of Representatives. I'll be in my ethnic attire. I'll be talking about issues that are close to their heart. There is the environment and culture domain. I'm going to also do it in other regions, no? So Mindanao, even sa Visayas, kasi the most marginalized of IPs are actually the IPs in Visayas.
If you don't win, Teddy, what role would you like to take in government if Leni Robredo makes it? If she wins, what position or what role would you like to take?
Well, if she offers and she asks me, you choose. Then something to do with natural resources management.
Like DENR? Like you want to be DENR secretary?
Like yes, the DENR or the Department of Agriculture. Because this is my expertise naman as a former governor and congressman. Uh-oh. It's always been.
So what would you do about mining? I mean, now that you've mentioned it just very quickly, we saw how the late Gina Lopez's battle against mining turned out.
Yeah, yeah.
If you were DENR secretary.
I'll be the incarnation of Gina Lopez, IP style.
Uh-oh.
Which is really about consensus building. There's a law that we've been pushing.
So you are not against mining, or you are against mining?
I'm not saying that we should stop mining. Mining is still part of the economy, but I'm open to declaring no-go mining zones, whether it's prime agricultural lands or critical watersheds, bringing back the ban on open-pit mining. So, kumbaga, we have to explain that the Philippines is an archipelago, and, you know, pag small islands ka, and then you have mine in the midst of these small islands, grabe yung impact niya sa agriculture and tourism. So, if I were to choose, I'd choose agriculture, tourism over mining. That's my personal position when it comes to developing the economy. But we still need minerals. Mm. And the thing is, even if we have all of these minerals, we ship them overseas. That's our mining industry. So sa akin, let's really have a new mining law, which the processing of the mineral ore is in the Philippines para hindi iba nakikinabang, and declaring areas na talaga as no-go mining zones. That's my position when it comes to mining.
All right. On that note, Teddy Baguilat, good luck to you, sir. And I guess, what's your number on the ballot?
Number four.
Oh, number four. Well, good luck to you, sir. I hope to speak with you
again. Thanks, Karen. Thank you very much.